today I feel proud to say that I am going to complete 200th episode with the title of ISKCON and its services. So far, all my near and dear friends and relatives and all well-wishers supported me. Otherwise, I can't complete this task of 200 episodes in different topics, subjects, burning topics and various mythological and scientific and various legends, etc. Each and everything I completed mean because of your encouragement only. So, on this occasion of 200th episode, I plead you and all, not only you who subscribe, you also refer your near and dear friends and relatives to subscribe and get details of the ancient culture and tradition of India. It is must and should the duty of yours to propagate, first of all, those who are not subscribed, complete now itself. And if you are completed subscription, then encourage others to get subscribed. Then only my task of completing or fulfilling my ambition towards the future generation. Let us come to the topic of ISKCON temple, ISKCON's, its services. We all know God has 10 avatars, that is called Dasha Avatara, especially by Lord Vishnu. Among 10 avatars, 10 incarnations, Lord Krishna is considered as God of the universe. That's why Bhagavatam says, Krishnastu Bhagavan Swayam. Because in other incarnation, it is a temporary, only the purpose, that is Kamsha Avatara or Avesha Avatara, etc. But in full-fledged avataram, we can see from Lord Krishna. When we utter the word of Krishna, Krishna, Akarshana, us, the word itself makes us towards Lord Krishna. In this way, we are really fortunate to have so many seers, so many devotees who were attached with the Lord Krishna with their deep devotion. For example, we can say Lord Krishna is very much attached with his friend Sudama Kuchela. Kuchela's devotion is a friendly devotion, Sakya Bhakti, Arjuna. He is a pure devotee of Lord Krishna. Whatever Krishna say, he follows simply, blindly also. Even we can see so many devotees who were devoted their lives for Lord Krishna's devotion. Among them, we can see Acharya Nimbarka, Meera Boy from North India. Purely she devoted her life and treated Lord Krishna, her husband. Even Chaitanya Prabhu and Jayadeva, he composed Gita Govindam only on Lord Krishna and his love towards Radha. See, what a beautiful composition of Gita Govindam by Jayadeva, who was considered, treated as devotee of Lord Krishna. Krishna. Even Sant Tukaram, we can say proudly, one of the devotee of Lord Krishna. Now, the present topic is ISKCON. ISKCON is one of the famous worldwide organization. It means International Society for Krishna Consciousness. It is founded by A.C. Bhakti Vedanta Swami Prabhupada. Today, I chose topic of Lord Krishna for my 200th episode, because Lord Krishna, who will please with our prayers and shower his blessings not only on me, even those who are watching this video and their families and everyone gets the fulfillment of their desires with the blessings of Lord Krishna. Let us devote purely with our 100% devotion, because Lord Krishna, none other than other God, can save us. Even in the crisis situation, if we chant the name of Krishna, all the evils will disappear at once. For this Krishna's devotees, we can find A.C. Bhakti Vedanta Swami Prabhupada, who came forward by establishing an organization called ISKCON. Let us see the detailed description of ISKCON and its services in detail. First prayer. Krishnaya Vasudevaya Devaki Nandanaya cha Nandagopa Kumaraya Govindaya Namo Namaha. Here we have to pray Lord Krishna, because unless his blessings, we can't move even a single step. Let us see. The ISKCON means International Society for Krishna Consciousness, known colloquially as the Hare Krishna Movement or Hare Krishna, is a Gaudiya Vaishnava religious organization. ISKCON was founded in 1966 in New York City by A.C. Bhakti Vedanta Swami Prabhupada. Its core beliefs are based on the Vedic scriptures, particularly we can say by Bhagavad Gita and the Bhagavata Purana and Gaudiya Vaishnava tradition, which has had adherence in India since the 15th century and American and European devotees since the early 90s. The organization was formed to spread the practice of Bhakti Yoga, the practice of love of God, in which those mean bhaktas, devotees involved to dedicate their thoughts and actions towards pleasing Krishna, the Supreme Lord. Its most rapid expansion in membership of 2007 have been within India, and especially after the collapse of Soviet Union in Russia, Ukraine, and arrest of the ex-Soviet aligned states of Eastern Europe and Central Asia. Today, it has around 1 million congregational members worldwide, including 15,000 in the UK. As of June 2019, and despite the relatively small number of followers in the West, it has been described as influential. Let us see history and belief. Pancha Tattva deities, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Nityananda, Advaita Acharya, Gandhara, and Srinivasa, installed in a Gaudiya Vaishnava temple. These five are root cause of this. ISKCON devotees follow a disciplined line of Gaudiya Bhagavata Vaishnava and are the largest branch of Gaudiya Vaishnavism. Vaishnavism means nothing, worship of Lord Vishnu. And Gauda refers to the area where this particular branch of Vaishnavism originated, in the Gauda region of West Bengal. Gaudiya Vaishnavism had a following in India, especially West Bengal and Orisha, for the past 500 years. Gaudiya Vaishnavism was founded by the Saint Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, who rapidly spread off his form of ecstatic, mean ecstatic bhakti throughout Bengal. He established a Sankirtan, mean the practice of publicly expressing devotion of Lord Krishna, the Supreme God, through dance and song. Chaitanya emphasized chanting the Hare Krishna Mahamantra. He is considered as by Gaudiya Vaishnavas to be incarnation of Krishna himself. Bhakti Vedanta Swami Prabhupada brought Chaitanya's Gaudiya Vaishnavism to the West in 1965. At 16 years old, he landed in New York without any money. Instead of preaching to New York's elite, he tapped into the 1960s countercultural spirit by preaching and chanting public parks and attracting hippies and the youth. His movements, the known as Hare Krishna movement, grew even larger when he relocated to San Francisco a year later. Key to the spread of Gaudiya Vaishnava theory or theology in the Western world was Bhakti Vedanta Swami Prabhupada's extensive writings and translations, including Bhagavad Gita. As it is Srimad Bhagavatam, Chaitanya Charitamrita, and other scriptures. These works now available in more than 70 languages and serve as the scriptures of ISKCON. ISKCON described Krishna as the source of all the avatars of God. Thus, ISKCON devotees worship Krishna as the highest form of God, Swayam Bhagavan, and often refer to him as the Supreme Personality of Godhead in writing, which was a phrase coined by Prabhupada in his books on the subject. To devotees, Radha represents Krishna's divine female counterparts, the original spiritual potency and the embodiment of divine love. The most famous and publicly recognizable ISKCON practice is Kirtan, a congregational chanting or singing of the Hare Krishna mantra. It's both a way to express devotion to God and a way to attract newcomers to the movement. Devotees gather in public, in streets and parks to sing the mantra, accompanied by instruments like the mridanga, hand cymbals and the harmonium. During the 1970s, ISKCON entered the public eye because of this practice. Devotees would sing and distribute books, proselytize in airports and all public areas, often obtrusively. Sankirtana continues throughout the world today, but in a less confrontational manner. Other important religions practiced within ISKCON and Gaudiya Vaishnavism is Japa, or the meditative practice of repeatedly chanting the name of Krishna and a rosary beads. Okay, it's considered the only way for salvation for people in the current age. Another important practice within ISKCON is Arati. In Arati, devotees offer water, incense, a fire lamp and flowers to Murti, a sacred statue or image of Lord Krishna. This is accompanied by prayers and devotional songs called bhajans. Practitioners may perform Arati at their own home, congregate at a temple to join in this ceremony. ISKCON devotees meet regularly, typically on Sunday at a program known as Sunday Feast, to worship deities, listen to discourse by senior devotees, participate in kirtan and eat sanctified offered food. During initiation, means diksha, ISKCON devotees vow to follow four basic rules and regulations. What are they? No? One, to follow a lacto-vegetarian diet, not to consume any intoxicants, mean alcohol, cigarettes, drugs, tobacco, not to gamble, not to engage in illicit sex. Number two, besides weekly gatherings, devotees within ISKCON movement celebrate a diverse array in Hindu festival, including Janmashtami, Radhashtami, Diwali, Guru Purnima, Ekadasi, Holi, Sri Ramanavami and Geeta Jayanti. Especially third, another one. The Ratha Yatra festival of chariots is an annual parade whereby devotees chant and dance on the street, pulling a chariot with the deities of Lord Jagannath, Baladeva and Subhadra behind them. This public procession is typically followed by performances and free vegetarian food. According to doctrine of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, one does not need to be born in a Hindu family to take up the practice. There are ISKCON communities around the world with schools, restaurants and farms. Kirtan and music influences more in ISKCON. No? Small Kirtan. Bada chitta chor man mohan, mera chitta chor jagan mohan. Bada chitta chor man mohan, mera chitta chor jagan mohan. Ayodhya ke sitaram, Ayodhya ke sitaram, Vrindavan ke radhesham, Vrindavan ke radhesham. Bada chitta chor man mohan, mera chitta chor jagan mohan. The practice of mantra meditation, also known as kirtan, is prominent in the ISKCON movements. Dedicated kirtana festivals are held annually around the world, such as the Mayapuris, etc., who have all released kirtan albums. Kirtan sessions are also held outside the temple settings, including at a local university, bhakti clubs, mantra lounges, at yoga and wellness festivals. Full theatrical performances have been produced based on the Vedic mythologies. Prominent performance companies include Viva Kultura and Vande Arts. Especially ISKCON emphasizes more on vegetarianism. Vegetarianism is one of the four tenets of ISKCON, mean principles of ISKCON. With respect to A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada's focus on food distribution, many ISKCON devotees have opened vegan and vegetarian eateries based on the Vedic non-violent eating principles. These include the formal Govinda's food chain, mean donut plant and enlightened eating. Not all restaurants opened by ISKCON members are officially affiliated with ISKCON. Although many Govinda's restaurants or catering business operate out of the main temple center, they maintain charitable projects. Let us see some charitable: cow protection and ISKCON WP. International Society for Cow Protection was designed to present alternatives to agricultural and dietary practices that support and depend upon the meat and dairy industry's slaughter of innocent animals, especially the cow. Their philosophy of compassionate cow protection stems from the Hindu Vedic value of ahimsa or non-violence and the deity Krishna's affection for cows and butter. ISCO WP, mean ISCOWP, believes that the tenets of cow production are universal and non-sectarian, available to all regardless of race, creed or nationality. ISKCON has a number of cow production farms and centers known as goshalas around the world in farming communities and temples. In 2018, Geeta Nagari Eco Farm and Sanctuary was the only USDA, mean USDA, certified slaughter-free dairy production facility in the United States. ISKCON has a tribal care trust. It is an ISKCON affiliate which aims at providing socio-economical development to the tribal people. The trust has set up schools and potable water sources for the tribal people. They also distribute blankets and study materials to the tribal communities. Food for Life Global. It is managed by ISKCON devotees but ultimately unaffiliated with the ISKCON movement. Food for Life Global is a not-for-profit vegan food relief organization with 211 international affiliates. The organization predicts Food for Life volunteers distribute 20 lakhs free meals daily through outreach to the homeless, school lunch programs, orphanages, and for victims of natural disasters or calamities. Notable missions include food distribution during the Chechen wars and during the aftermath of Hurricane Katrina. There is international debate as to whether food distribution effort should be required to include religious preaching, prayer, or book distribution, but as of 2020, this is not mandated by the organization. However, food distributed in these missions as per customs by the ISKCON movement is often offered to temple deities prior to distribution. Let us see the ISKCON management structure. The governing body commission was created by him in 1970 in a document direction of management written in 28th July 1970, Prabhupada appointed 12 members to the commission, all of them non-sannyasi, including Satswarupa Dasa Goswami, Hamsadatta Swami and Tamala Krishna Goswami. The letter outlined the purposes of the commission: improving the standard of temple management, the spread of Krishna consciousness, the distribution of books and literature, the opening of new centers and the education of the devotees. GBC has since grown in size to include 48 senior members from the movement who make decisions based on consensus of opinion. Let us see, succession of teachings. ISKCON Guru System. Chanting beads normally of Tulasi wood given by an ISKCON guru at the invitation of an ISKCON devotee of Krishna. ISKCON's founder A.C. Bhakti Vedanta Swami Prabhupada claimed to belong to the traditional system of parampara or disciplic succession in which teachings upheld by scriptures are handed down from master to disciple generation after generation. Youth ministry. Most ISKCON temples offer Sunday school services for children of devotees during the weekly program. The curriculum of these classes may vary by location. ISKCON Pandava Sena, another group. Based out of Bhakti Vedanta Manor of Watford, UK, ISKCON Pandava Sena is a youth organization that aims to connect like-minded souls to the timeless philosophy of the Vedas. The organization started in 1994 and is now composed of a variety of professional and university students that host annual international mentorship and reunion retreats and weekly social gatherings. Pandavasena has also established Krishna Conscious Societies across 30 universities in the UK alone, bring spirituality based programming to students and working professionals. Many universities have similar student groups featuring youth from local ISKCON temples congregating for yoga, vegan food or mantra meditation based on the Krishna Conscious Society's model. The Sangha Initiative is a similar organization that is based in the United States and hosts an annual youth retreat And camping trip for is called children called Camp Ignite. Is called Vaishnavi Ministry, another branch. Women's roles are a controversial issue within ISKCON, and its members have strongly divergent opinions regarding the interpretation of Srila Prabhupada's teachings on gender roles. While some of its leaders advocate that women should take public leadership roles, other leaders disagree and maintain that traditional roles for women are more appropriate. They fear an undesirable influence on secular feminism within ISKCON. According to the essay Women in ISKCON in Prabhupada's time, written by Jyotirmayi Devi Darashi, women are renowned within ISKCON and regarded as completely equal in regards to spirituality. Prabhupada, in his original writings, encouraged the complete equality of women in the eye of Krishna based on the teachings of Bhagavad Gita that soul does not have any gender, everybody is eligible for spirituality liberation. Since mother is the most respected position in Vedic culture, Matru Devo Bhava, women within the Hare Krishna community are all viewed as mothers, especially by celibate male members, brahmacharis. Mother is a term of respect for women in the International Society for Krishna Consciousness and is often prefixed to the Sanskrit name they receive initiation. Even unmarried women are referred to as mothers. See the greatness of the respect given to the woman in ISKCON. Malati Devi Dasi is the first woman appointed to the ISKCON Governing Body Commission, that is called GBC. After years of discussion and reforms, a general consensus emerged to accept women as leaders and initiators is ISKCON. In 1998, Malati Devi Dasi became the first woman appointed to the GBC. The second woman leader, Deena Sharana, was selected in 2009. An updated document was released by the GBC in 2019 stating that it was permissible for women to become initiating gurus within ISKCON community and ISKCON movement. The ministry was developed to account for the growing interest of female devotees to partake in temple practices and ensure representation in decision making. Let us see, significant organization of ISKCON. The Grihastha Vision Team provides premarital parenting and family counseling services to member of any Vaishnava community. The team is made of volunteers who are mental health and educational professionals outside the religious community. Started in 2002, ISKCON Resolve is a neutral, confidential and informal conflict resolution service for ISKCON congregation members and leaders. Services provided include ombudsman services, conflict meditation services, and self-help tools. The ISKCON Domestic Abuse Coalition's mission is to raise awareness of within ISKCON and provide valuable resources for victims' leadership and community at large. ISKCON has a friendly relationship with other religious societies, seeing them as contributing in inculcating spiritual values in people. In a historic first, ISKCON brought together the four Vaishnava Sampradayas for a Sankirtana festival in the year 2015. It also has been organizing Vaishnava Christian dialogues in the West to propagate the consciousness of Krishna, God, as it is revealed in the great scriptures of India, that is Bhagavad Gita and Srimad Bhagavatam. To teach and encourage the Sankirtana movement, congregational chanting of the holy name of God, Lord Krishna, as revealed in the teachings of Lord Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. To bring the members closer together for the purpose of teaching in simpler, more natural way of life, with a view towards achieving the aforementioned purposes, to publish and distribute periodical magazines, books and other writings. Thus, ISKCON stands for its services to humankind on the name of Lord Krishna. We should thank ISKCON, those who are really doing service to the humankind on the name of Lord Krishna. Let us offer our salutation to A.C. Bhakti Vedanta Swami Prabhupada. ಶ್ರೀಯಕಾಂತಾಯ ಕಲ್ಯಾಣ ನದೇ ನಿದೇ ದಿನಾಂ ಶ್ರೀ ವೆಂಕಟ ನಿವಾಸಾಯ ಶ್ರೀವಾಸಾಯ ಮಂಗಳಂ ಮಂಗಳಾಶಾಸನವರೈರ್ ಮದಾಚಾರ್ಯ ಪುರೋಗಮೈ ಸರ್ವೈಶ್ಚ ಪೂರ್ವೈರಾಚಾರ್ಯೈ ಸಕೃತಾಯಾಸ್ತು ಮಂಗಳಂ.